blood pressure is a really important factor to affect our heart health and our risk for heart disease. And if you do have high blood pressure, it's really important that you monitor it at home so you can help your doctor make sure you're on the best dose and treatment for your high blood pressure. And that means it's important to have a blood pressure monitor device at home. So I have one here on the table. This is a blood pressure measurement device meant and designed to be used at home. There are a number of them that you can find at your local pharmacy. You can talk with your pharmacist about what they would advise as a good one to use. And when you're trying to make sure it's working well for you, a good idea is to take it in when you see your doctor and have it compared with the blood pressures that you get in the office to make sure what you get with your machine is similar to what your doctor gets when you're in the office. And you know you're getting good numbers. But it's also important to take your blood pressure using good methods. And that means being careful not to exercise or drink caffeinated beverages, and certainly don't smoke within about a half an hour of checking your blood pressure. You really shouldn't be smoking anyway, right? And then when you are going to check your blood pressure, make sure you empty your bladder before you do that, because if your bladder's full, you know, that'll increase your blood pressure. And then follow good blood pressure measurement technique. Make sure you have a cup that's the right size for your arm. Put it on your arm up above your elbow. It's best if you don't have it over clothing. It should be really on your skin, not on your shirt. You should rest comfortably in a chair for about 5 minutes before you take your blood pressure. You should make sure your feet are flat on the floor, not crossed, not your legs crossed. Your back should be supported by the chair you're sitting in, like the chair I'm sitting in now. And your arms should be supported on the table so that you're not holding your arm up while you're getting your blood pressure checked, because that increases your blood pressure because it increases the tension in your arm. So you rest, you relax, you make sure you're seated correctly, have the cuff on your arm, and you measure your blood pressure. It's best to do it a couple of times and separated by a couple of minutes. Record that for your doctor, so you take it in when you see your doctor and share that information. Some devices keep that information in a memory. Others, you know, you'll need to write it down in a little logbook. It's a good idea to check your blood pressure during the week, a couple of days each week at different times of day, so that you can see how your blood pressure tends to be in the morning, how it tends to be in the afternoon, how it tends to be in the evening, but always follow good blood pressure measurement technique. So if you are looking for a way to keep track of your blood pressure readings at home, check out hearttruth.gov. We've got a lot of tools there that'll help you track your blood pressure. Also, wonderful resource for other things to help you learn more about how to improve your heart health.